Hey guys, it's Margaret with Sassy Southern Shopper Mom. Thank you so much for coming back to my channel. Today I am sharing 5 tips for a successful homeschool day. So if you want to check out these tips, just keep watching. But first, let me tell you a little bit about this collaboration. This is an open collaboration, a homeschool show and tell. And it is hosted by Abby from Rooted in Rest and Jessica from The Wall Duct Way. So I am gonna link this open collaboration down below in my description box. So make sure you go down there, hit that link, and watch some of these other tips for a successful homeschool day. All right guys, so don't forget to go ahead and hit that subscribe button down below, hit your bell notification for you don't miss any other videos, and hit a thumbs up for this homeschool video as well. If you are new to homeschooling, this show and tell homeschool collaboration really kind of just shows you how unique and diverse the whole world of homeschooling is, and that no one way is the right way and no one way is the wrong way. But let's go ahead and get into my 5 tips to a successful homeschool day. All right guys, so my tip number 1 is to start the night before. A good, successful homeschool day, I feel like, always starts the night before. And you might hear this on other videos as well, but I truly in my heart feel like a good, successful homeschool day starts the night before. Those kiddos have got to get some sleep. Just, they're growing kids. They need the sleep, and you need the sleep too. So not only get your kids in bed at a decent time so that you can have a good, successful homeschool day, but get yourself to bed a little bit earlier just for that you can get some rest. So tip number 1 is just really start the night before. Tip number 2, and this might come as a surprise because I just said get more rest, but get up before your kids get up. If I do not get up before my kids get up and I am getting ready for the day and they are, per se, like under my feet while I'm trying to get ready, I just get overwhelmed and stressed out like first thing in the morning, and then that just carries on through my whole day, including our homeschool day. So just kind of getting up in the morning, even if it's just to get up 10 minutes before your kiddos so that you can get dressed, get your brush, your face washed, your teeth brushed, maybe get a little bite to eat before you have to fix them something, but just get up a little bit before they do, just to start your morning out calm and quiet and relaxed, so that hopefully it will roll over into your homeschool day and it will help you have a successful homeschool day. Tip number 3. Tip number 3 for me is plan, plan, plan. Plan ahead a little bit, guys. It's okay to plan ahead, and it's okay to change those plans if something changes or happens. That is the beauty of homeschooling. Something happens or changes, you just go with the flow and freely change your homeschool day. But the thing is to plan, have a plan. I usually sit down on Fridays while my daughter is doing her homeschool work. And I will kind of look over everything that we kind of want to learn for the next week. And I will write it out and I will plan it out for each day. We'll do a little bit each day on this or whatever. But I kind of plan my next week out starting on Friday. I was doing it on Sundays, but now I work day shift instead of night shift, so I'm at work all day on Sundays instead of sleeping all day at home. But I just like to plan ahead. I like to have a plan. I like to be somewhat organized on this stuff because it is my daughter's education, and education is so important to me. It's God, family, and right now, because she's little, education. It's education and play and fostering, you know, the love of learning. So I like to just plan so that I am not coming into it on Monday or midweek going, oh my God, frantically, what am I doing today? What am I teaching? Because that is not gonna lead to a successful day. You will be stressed out. Your kids will be overwhelmed. Or if you are like, oh my God, I totally forgot, you know, whatever this week and we really needed to do it this week, and then you've got to add it in on a day that your kid might be overwhelmed or you might be overwhelmed, it's just not going to be successful that day. So just try and plan ahead, even if maybe it's just a couple of days in advance, 2 to 3 days in advance. Just plan ahead every couple of days. For me, I like to plan ahead on Friday for the whole next week. So just plan ahead a little bit so that in the morning you already know the goals and the things you kind of want to teach and want them to learn for the day. Tip number 4 is to have a routine. Have something that you do every morning in your homeschool day that the kids can kind of just get into the routine, and eventually they'll become a little more independent with it too, and give you a little, you can step back a little bit and they will kind of take over. So just giving them a routine is good. Young children, believe it or not, actually thrive off of having a routine set. And I actually love having a routine as well. I thrive on a routine as well. So having a good routine for your homeschool morning, like when you start your morning out, will help you have a successful homeschool day. For us personally, which this might not work for everybody, but for us personally, I like to have my kids, when we come into the homeschool room, they know, they're 7 and 3, they know now that we are gonna do the pledge, we are gonna do the days of the week song, we are gonna do the months of the year song, then we listen to the Star Spangled Banner and America the Beautiful, and then we have our calendar time where they get to do what today is, what tomorrow is going to be, and what yesterday was. Then they get to look at the weather and we get to graph it, stuff like that. So it's just a small little routine that takes maybe 10 minutes total, but they know that routine and now they can come up and pop everything into place and do everything on their own. They get up here and they do their pledge and they sing their songs. They've been pulling out music instruments when they sing. So it's just a routine that they're accustomed to, that they know. It just kind of gets us going in the morning. So just having some type of homeschool routine is really good. Another routine that we have in our homeschool is at the beginning of the year, I let my daughter pick out what subjects she wanted to do, like in order of what subjects she wanted to do each day. Now, some days she'll be like, I don't want to do social studies right now. I'd rather do math. Or I don't want to do spelling and writing. I want to do science or math. So we'll change it up occasionally. But for the most part, she's pretty consistent in her own routine. She made the routine herself. So she's eager to do what she picked out, how she picked it out. So having your kids be a part of that routine as well and helping them make decisions to make a certain routine is also another really helpful tip with getting that routine going. Tip number 5, our last tip for a successful homeschool day, is to take breaks, guys. They are kids. We are fostering fun learning, the love of learning. So taking breaks, even if it's you do 2 subjects and then you take a 10 minute break or a 15 minute break, just take breaks throughout your day. My kiddos love to take breaks. They love to get Play-Doh. I have like toys and music stuff back here. They love to get those out. They love to read some of our books, which you know, is still learning. They're still learning when they read, guys. So if it's an activity you want to do, no matter what it is, in some way, it is going to foster learning for them. It's going to be fun for them. So just remember to take breaks. They're kids. A lot of times kids can't sit for an extended amount of time. Even kids in public school, if you look at how a teacher will teach a class, they will take some type of break in between. It's called brain breaks. They'll get up and get their wiggles out and do a little dancing. Our favorite thing is Go Noodle. If you've ever tried it, you can just Google it and look it up. But Go Noodle is really fun. Kids love it a lot. Even just finding something on YouTube to dance and sing to. Just take a brain break. Get away from the book studies of learning and make learning fun. Have those breaks and let them enjoy their days. And that, I really do think that helps you have a successful homeschool day. Okay guys, so those were my 5 tips for a successful homeschool day. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button down below. I would really love for you to go ahead and come on over and join my YouTube family. If you like this video, I will again have the link to the show and tell for 5 successful tips for a homeschool day down in my description box. And thank you, Jessica and Abby, for hosting this open collaboration. Next month is going to be our favorite subject. So I can't wait to see everyone's favorite subject, and I can't wait to share my favorite subject that I like to teach to my kids with you as well. As always, I will see you in the next one. Bye, guys.